A very warm welcome to all of you. This is our third conversation with Mr. Anshuman Rajhans, who secured 11th rank in the Indian Forest Service examination and 356th rank in the Civil Service examination. Mr. Anshuman has also faced this year's Civil Service interview, the result of which is awaited in the later part of this year. So in this part of discussion, we are going to start from exactly the point where we left in our second conversation. So in the second conversation, we spoke about how to utilize our time and what are the things to focus upon for the Civil Service Main Examination 2020. In this discussion, we are going to focus upon the needs of those candidates who are going to also write Indian Forest Service examination. So between the Civil Service Main and Indian Forest Service examination this year, you have a very narrow space of time. But right now, if you look at it, you must be preparing your optional for the Civil Service Main, and you are actually having the responsibility to cover one more optional and then reorient yourself for the general studies of IFS, which the UPSC calls general knowledge. And we also have to prepare a bit for the English paper, because we cannot forget that the English paper of IFS, its marks are added to your final score, and that will be deciding the selection and the eventual rank. So all of this, what we have to do, what are the focus areas, what are the avoidable mistakes for the Indian Forest Service Main Examination, that's what we are going to talk in this part.
I personally think that what one needs to do before Civil Services Mains, that will depend from aspirant to aspirant. One thing is that what is his or her optional. So if optional is common, then definitely there will be different strategy. If the two optionals are new to them, then definitely that will be a new case, and they will be having a different sort of strategy. And one thing is that regarding Indian Forest Services Mains, 300 marks general English paper is there, 300 marks general knowledge paper is there, 400 marks optional 1 and 400 marks optional 2. So regarding general GK paper, definitely it is presumed that one would have given Civil Services Mains. So definitely one would be having holistic understanding and a revision of the general studies, because he or she would have given the Civil Services Mains. And regarding English also, definitely it is presumed that one would have studied a lot for the essay paper that is there in Civil Services. So that will definitely help in Forest Services Mains also. And if one optional is common, then definitely it is presumed that he or she would have prepared that optional in a well-fastened manner. And if it is new, both optionals are new, then definitely what I personally suggest, that just after the prelims is over, one should at least dedicate 1 week for IFS mains optional, if one would be approaching IFS. Because ऐसा होता है कि roughly 2 या 3 दिन की छुट्टियाँ तो हर कोई लेता है prelims देने के बाद, लेकिन वो एक हफ्ता तक linger कर जाता है. तो 2 या 3 दिन की छुट्टियाँ लेना तो definitely healthy है, just in order to have efficient study after that. But definitely उसके 4 या 5 दिन तक one can have some sort of reading to the extent possible of the optionals that one would be having in the Indian Forest Services. क्योंकि वो time तो ऐसे utilize नहीं हो रहा है, लेकिन उसको better utilize करना, अगर Forest Services का mains देना ही है, तो that will be the best way of utilizing that time. So these are the presumptions that I personally think कि इतना तक होना चाहिए, and after then one can proceed forward. मैं यहाँ तक कहूँगा कि डेफिनेटली जनरल स्टडीज़ की प्रिपरेशन ऑन एन एवरेज 90-95% तो ओवर हो गई होगी, क्योंकि सिविल सर्विसेज का मेंस बंदे ने दे दिया है. लेकिन डेफिनेटली द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस, इवन द वे ऑफ आंसरिंग, that is slightly different from the Civil Services Mains. And even one has to prepare certain extra topics, because 300 marks का total general knowledge का paper होता है, तो इसमें total 6 sections होते हैं. 50 marks के 6 sections होंगे. One is history, one is geography, one is polity, one is economy, one is science and technology, and one is ecology and environment. तो मेरा ये मानना है कि जो geography, economy और polity का section होता है, तो one what one has studied for civil services general studies, that will suffice for Indian Forest Services also. But definitely one has to go and consult the previous year question papers of Indian Forest Service in order to see what are the type of questions, the manner of questions that is asked. But definitely one would not have to study extra. But current affairs one has to go through for the last 2 or 3 months, because the GK paper will be 2 months after the civil services mains. And regarding history, in civil services, the main focus is on modern India. One or two questions is from art and culture on. But in forest services, and the questions from ancient India and medieval India comes. Because Mansabdari system was a repetitive topic for Indian Forest Services GK paper. And even the questions from Aryan Age or Indus Valley Civilization, that are asked in the Indian Forest Services. So 50 mark question, 50 mark section is there of history. So roughly 20 marks from modern India, 15 from ancient medieval is there. So one has to read ancient medieval. So I would have read, because one would have faced the prelims, and in prelims Indian Forest Services cutoff is high, so one would have definitely read ancient and medieval also. But certain topics are repetitive, like Mansabdari system, Dhamma policy of Asoka, so one can prepare notes in an elongated manner of these topics. And apart from that, science and tech and ecology and environment, those are there in civil services GS paper 3. But definitely a lot of questions and in-depth questions are not asked. But in forest services, in-depth questions are asked. For example, I can quote one example that one scheme of government is there in order to assess the quality of the soil, that is soil health card. So UPSC civil services mains will only ask about soil health card effectiveness. But in Indian Forest Services, a device is particularly used called Mrida Parikshak. So even that question came in 2017 or 18 paper. So definitely more technical questions are also asked in ecology and environment and science and technology. So while one is going through the preparation of science and technology and environment in civil services GS part, so one should know that certain technical aspects should be done there, then and there only, because that will help in the Indian Forest Services GK paper. And even the syllabus of Indian Forest Services GK paper says that the word, I cannot recall the exact word, but wording is such that the technical aptitude of the students will be checked. These kind of words is there. So definitely one has to show certain technical aspect. Even for Indus Valley Civilization question comes, then one can compare with the smart city and show certain that what those things that were there in the Indus Valley Civilization city planning, that can be imitated in the smart city project. So that certain technical aspect can be shown by the candidates, that can definitely help. And regarding the approach of the question and the way of answering, in civil services, more amount of space is there. So one is forced to write certain more, analyze in a longer manner, draw some diagrams. But in Indian Forest Services, what happens, the amount of space that is given for writing the answers, that varies from year to year. In 2017, there was only one page for the 10 marker question, but in civil services, there will be 2 pages. So one has to, in that particular situation, one has to write the keywords then and there only, to the point answers should be written. One cannot elaborate in a detailed manner. But in 2018, when I faced the Indian Forest Services GK paper, a lot of space was there. So the demand was there that one has to write in an elaborate manner. So one should be prepared that the spacing changes are being done in GK paper of Indian Forest Services. So accordingly, one has to change the plan then and there only in the examination hall. Regarding English preparation, definitely, sir, 300 marks English paper is there. And if I look at the score that toppers get, even 160 to 170 marks, that is common among the top 20 or top 30 aspirants who get into the services. And I personally think that if one is good at English, then definitely one can easily get 130 to 140 marks. And one has to change that particular level from 130, 135 to 160, 165. So if one prepares, then definitely one can get an edge of 30 to 40 marks. And that 30 to 40 marks helps a lot, because one can be easily out of the list or one can easily get into the list. And that preparation doesn't require much time. Even one dedicates, if one is good at it, good at English up to the 10th or 12th standard, and if one dedicates roughly about 5 days for English preparation, that will be more than enough. But that 5 days preparation is required. So what I used to do, I used to read from morning till afternoon or till evening time optional papers. But at the end, when I used to lose energy, I used to consult English related grammar aspects or what those things that are being asked. So 100 marks essay paper is there, 50 50 marks comprehension and precis is there, and 25-25 letter and report is there, and 50 marks grammar is there. Regarding essay, the same strategy as it is applied for essay paper of civil services can be applied. But definitely here one needs to know that more focus will be there on the English part and the grammatical aspect. If one grammatical mistake is there in the civil services essay paper, definitely one will lose mark, but here he will lose more mark because the grammatical aspect will be checked. And there are four topics, one has to choose one, and one of the topics will be there with respect to environment and ecology. It can be pollution, it can be climate change, or it can be conservation of biodiversity. So these three or four topics can be prepared in an elaborate manner, so one can easily attempt one essay because that will be there from the environment related topic. And even if one is not familiar with attempting topics related to environment, that is also okay. So he or she then can choose other topics if he or she is calm at it in choosing that particular topic. And regarding comprehension and precise writing, I personally think that it should be written in own words. The main problem is that one used to copy directly from the comprehension. So extra edge can be taken if one writes what is asked and what is there in the comprehension, but in his or her own words. That will give advantage. And regarding letter and report, I personally don't think that lot of advantage can be taken, but definitely one has to write in the proper format. And if practices letter or report of last 1 or 2 years, even the whole English paper for the last 1 or 2 years, the previous year question papers for last 1 or 2 years for English can be practiced, that will definitely help. And regarding grammar, definitely a lot of leverage can be taken. If one is attempting grammar without any revision, so one would be getting about 30 marks correct out of 50. And after revising the basic things only, like changing from noun to adjective, or even direct to indirect, transformation of sentences, error correction, one can easily get 45 to 47 marks correct out of 50. And even full correct can be there, but okay, if two or three things can get wrong, so 47 to 48 marks can be corrected. So definitely there can be leverage of about 30 to 40 marks. If one prepares English just only for 4 to 5 days, and that is enough, but that has to be done. Regarding optionals, optional 1 and optional 2, it is 800 marks out of 1700, so I would say roughly 50% weightage is there. And even one thinks in a strategic manner, in English one can easily take advantage if he or she just studies for 5 days. That is more than enough. In GK, if one is good at it in civil services, he will definitely be good at it in the forest services also. And in interview also, there is no very much divergence is not there as it is in civil services interview process. So the lot of the selection aspect depends on his or her performance in the optionals, optional 1 and optional 2. That is the main thing that decides selection. So one would be in two cases. One case is that the optional is common, like a person is having mathematics optional, so optional 1 for IFS is mathematics, and certain different optional will be there. Most probably it will be forestry, because it is seen that forestry is the most common optional. 95 to 99% of the persons appearing for this exam chooses this optional, and there can be cases where both the optionals are new to them. So if both the optionals are new, I personally think that at least basic reading of one of the optionals should be done right after the prelims in 1 week. And after the civil services means if that both the optionals are new, so one can dedicate 1 month for one optional and 1 month for the other optional. Or if one is comfortable, then 6 hours study for optional 1 and 6 hours study for optional 2. And if the optional is common, let's say if maths is the common optional, then one can easily revise the mathematics in 5 to 10 days. So the remaining days, that is 50 days, can be reserved for the new optional. Regarding IFS test series, definitely seeing the amount of competition that is presently there, so test series will definitely help. But I will not say that one should attempt before the civil services means, because a lot of load will be there, because only 3 months are there and revision has to be done, then test series of the civil services means of GS optionals and essay papers, and then final revision. So definitely test series should be done after civil services means, but definitely it should be done, because the sheer amount of competition is such that roughly 85 to 90 seats are there. and getting that particular seat. Nowadays it is seen that maximum of the aspirant who pass through the prelims stage will now appear for the mains also. So that leads to a lot amount of competition, and in order to get that particular advantage, so one has to make notes, one has to attempt the test series. Because earlier what used to be there in 2015-16, the competition was not so much fierce in Indian Forest Services. So even one was reading the basic book, for example, if I take the example of forestry, even one would be reading Manikandan and Prabhu or writing one or two tests, that will suffice. But definitely seeing the sheer amount of competition that is nowadays, so that reading of Manikandan definitely will not suffice. One has to read extra books also that is there of forestry. One has to make self-made notes, revise properly in a well-fastened manner. And apart from that, at least 3 to 4 tests should be attempted by the candidate, at least. And if time permits, then definitely he or she can attempt more tests, but 3 or 4 tests definitely should be attempted. If I focus on don'ts of IFS mains, regarding the papers, I can say in English, it usually happens that if essay gets backfired, generally one will get low score, and that can backfire up to 20 to 25 marks. So choose the topic of the essay properly and write a good fastened essay on it, and the best thing will be prepare certain topics with respect to ecology and environment. And with respect to the GS papers, the amount of space that is there in the examination hall that you will see will require whether you have to write in a detailed manner or to the point answer. So one should be prepared that much enough, because if to the point answer is required and you're writing in a detailed manner, the whole paper will backfire. So this thing I learned from my 2017 attempt. And apart from that, regarding the optionals are everything. If both the optionals are new, right from completion of the CSE mains, start preparing both the optionals, do holistic preparation. And in certain options like forestry, making diagrams, making explicit content definitely helps. And last minute revision is definitely of utmost importance. And in forest services, you have a time of roughly 3 to 4 days for revising optional one, and then 3 to 4 days for revising optional two. So make proper use of that time for a proper revision. And that will only be effective if one has made dedicated self-made notes.